We need technology to be a driver for advances in education and advances in knowledge discovery. But we find that our information technology people are spending most of their time provisioning direct services. And despite our best efforts, despite investment, we're unable to keep up with the exponential curve that people who are operating at a scale 1,000 times greater than us, despite the fact that at 65,000 students, we're a giant university. We're just unable to keep up with the speed of the internet. We're very early adopters of the Google Apps for Education suite. This is the suite of tools that Google is enriching almost on a monthly basis for us to be able to deploy collaboration and communication solutions to our students. The relationship that we established with Google made it clear to us that not only was their solution viable now, but that their solution going forward was going to get better at a rate that no one else was going to be able to do. And so in a very short period of time, over a period of about 2 weeks, we got together the decision makers at the university, did an analysis of what this would mean in terms of increasing our benefit, and we executed. We started with Gmail in the fall. We provisioned 65,000 email accounts that students have been adopting. When we released it, it was incredible. 300 students an hour converting from our homegrown web-based client to the Gmail client with really minimal marketing on our side. You know, we sort of braced ourselves because you make a major change in email. It's the lifeblood of a lot of students' communication. You make a change like that, you expect that you're going to experience difficulties. We were pleasantly surprised to see that where email, student email had been a source of a lot of our support calls, when we made this change, the calls went down almost immediately, and they have stayed down. So instead of us having a dedicated staff looking at how to provision email for students and how to increase the quota for students or how to make search better for the email for students, we now can focus on how to integrate collaboration tools into an environment to foster student success. And that can be very, very real. And it represents a major change for us at Arizona State that we have sufficient time and resources to begin to focus on the information environment and what it can do for students, how it can help them know how they're doing, know how they're progressing, make stronger advising decisions and career decisions. We will be completely converted by the end of the first quarter here. And at that time, we'll be able to turn off our mail system that we have maintained and invested in over the last 10 years. And we'll begin to see a savings of almost $500,000, about $400,000 a year. The cottage industry phase of IT is over. There are people operating at a scale 1,000 times what even large institutions like Arizona State University are operating at, where I have 30 dedicated staff looking at security. Google has thousands. The resources that Google has to keep my data safe, to keep my data private, far exceed my own. The principal benefit we see from a partnership with Google is the incredible acceleration of our ability to integrate technology. When we're on our own development curve, investing our own money and our own resources, we're able to advance at best linearly. Meanwhile, Google, operating at the scale of the internet, is able to innovate at a speed I think that's unprecedented in human history. And I know that sounds like an exaggeration, but it's no exaggeration to say that switching to the Google platform has been like getting technology from an advanced alien civilization. It has greatly accelerated our capability in a jump and has put us on a trajectory that we couldn't have reached on our own. Yeah, Google is making me look good.